Hi, Saggy. Welcome back to Dream Tarot. I'm here to do your what good things coming to you in April. We're going to do career, money, and love, okay? Before we get started, I do have a couple announcements. So I did just drop these new ANKH necklaces, and they're super cute. I'm wearing the one in gold, and this is the one in silver. Comes on a rope chain. So pretty. And yeah, they're on the website now if you're interested. These are new. They're packaged beautifully, like all my products, and they look so cute. So I'm going to be sporting this for a while because it's my new obsession. Also, I want to thank everybody who's been buying my energy clearing spray, my Palo Santo and White Sage energy clearing spray. A lot of you guys have been buying them in twos, which is so cool to me because I love that some of you guys are just buying two for yourself, but I love that you guys are sharing the products with other people that you think may find them useful. And I've been getting a lot of good reviews on that spray. Even a teacher reached out to me and she said that she sprays it in her classroom, and that made me feel so good. Sorry, I'm shaking the desk a little bit. We're going to try to keep it nice and cool. All right, so we're going to get started, guys. I do have hookah here. Now, the hookahs that I was selling, I only have one more, and that's going to sell out possibly tonight. So, you know, may the best man or woman win. But they're really nice. I also send you guys my hookah blend that I use, just in case you're curious. I send it to you in a 4-ounce jar. I send you two tips and a lollipop tip. So I take care of you guys. If you're interested, the link will be in the description box down below. If it's sold out, I'm sorry. You can always just request it to come back in stock. If you guys really want one, I'll make sure to get some more for you guys so I can send you guys those nice little packages. All right, so we're going to get started. I will be partaking in my hookah every once in a while. All right, so let's see what's coming towards my Saggies in their at work or career. So the song playing right now is Mutual Butterflies. So that's so weird. It's giving me Two of Cups energy. Some of you guys actually might fall for someone at work, or someone's falling for you, but the feeling will be mutual. This could also be Two of Cups energy in your career. You're loving your career, or in April, you'll really love your career or what you do for work. You're really going to fall in love all over again. So let's see what's coming towards you. Give me one card for Sagittarius for their career. Flexibility. Yeah. So some of you guys just love how flexible your career is going to be, or whatever you do for work, you're going to be able to do, like, work on your own schedule. You're finally going to get your own schedule finally, be able to make your own schedule finally. This could also mean, like, maybe if you're trying to take a vacation, your boss is just like, yes, you get approved right away. You're going to be able to work early if you want to and get off earlier, or work late if that's more of your forte. You're going to have weekends off or Fridays off. Like, something's going to work out for you. But I feel like definitely making your own schedule is going to be really big. But I also feel like it's going to be more easygoing. Like, I feel like all your hard work is kind of paying off. I kind of see, like, you see how this is, like, leading to the out here, like, where it's free. I feel like you're going to feel more free. Like, you can do more with your life. It's not going to just be work at home. You're going to be able to pick up hobbies or hang out with your friends or your boyfriend or your girlfriend more. I'm getting more so, like, carefree energy. So I feel like this is, like, all your hard work is finally paying off. What's on the bottom of this? We have embracing, and you'll be able to. So maybe too, some of you guys, your work is going to allow you more flexibility to be with someone that you're going to be connecting with in a romantic sense. But we'll talk about that in the love portion. So now I'm going to get some tarot for work. So what's happening for my Sagittarius career or work right now? What's happening for Sagittarius career or work in April? Okay, Four of Pentacles. I see you saving your money more. Whatever you make, you're going to save it, not spend it. I do see you having more outings, okay? We have the Three of Cups here. So I do see you having more you time, or time to spend with your friends. You're going to be going out more and just enjoying life, like getting ready for the summer. Springtime is going to be your time. Also, you see you saving your coin with the Four of Pentacles. Look, what did I just say? Didn't I just say the Two of Cups energy? That's what it was giving me. So what is going on at work? So some of you guys do have like a little, cute, like, you know, boo at work, or you're going to fall in love with work all over again. Let's see what's going on here with the Four of Pentacles. Two of Pentacles, okay? So you're going to be balancing your bank account again. So maybe you were spending way too much this beginning of this year. You're going to start saving. You're going to start seeing your money accumulate. You're going to start being a little bit more frugal with the Two of Pentacles. oh, is it worth spending on it? Okay, I'm gonna sleep on it. I'm gonna sleep on it and we'll see in the weekend. If I still want it, then I'll buy it. Feel like you're gonna be really thinking twice before making a big purchase here. What else? Okay, so this is leading into money. Eight of Swords. I see you kind of like being more strict. Four of Pentacles, Eight of Swords. Okay, being more strict about what you do when it comes to your career or the moves that you make, or even maybe staying on a schedule or a routine, or making sure that you're kind of like showing up better at work. And that's why you're going to get a more flexible schedule. So it's also balanced too, because you will have more free time. But it's kind of like, okay, you'll have more free time, but you'll also be very like strict about what you being on work on time or getting all your work done, or you know, moving up the corporate ladder or whatever you do for work, moving up. That's really big for you. But it also balances out, like with Temperance, which is your card, is that you have more of this free time. What's the Three of Cups? Also see a lot of people at work really wanting to hang out with you, or your friends wanting to hang out with you more. You also have the Seven of Cups, Three of Cups. Interesting. Ten of Cups, really crazy for career, okay? So really great things are happening for you. You're getting wish fulfillment, something to celebrate. You will celebrate something when it comes to work in April. I don't know what that is. Tell me more about that. High Priestess, something you were patient about. So if you're waiting for a raise or a promotion or to switch to a different department, or you're waiting for your schedule to be freed up, you're going to get that. You're going to be so in love with it. Ten of Cups is going to feel like a dream, something happening with work. And it's something that you're really patient for, but you will be celebrating it. So good for you. Okay, what's this Two of Cups energy for real? Judgment card, okay? It's like you're going to fall in love with your job all over again, because now you're getting a second chance at something that you were patient for or that you thought was long gone. Star card, okay? I feel like you stayed hopeful about something. You kind of didn't let it get the best of you. Just thought, okay, maybe not the right timing. Now it's coming in April. And I feel like because you stayed hopeful, because you still put like positive energy towards this, you're going to get it. And you'll be like feeling so complete at work or whatever you do in your career. So that's really good. A second chance or a second opportunity is coming back around again. Yeah, you were feeling kind of left out in a cold, but how did you react? Five of Pentacles. Ooh, Five of Swords. So there was some drama. So you did kind of throw a hissy fit with something at work. Okay. Okay. But the King of Wands, whoever your boss is or your superior is, or whoever is in your, whoever was watching you kind of throw this hissy fit, they see it more that you're going to fight for what you wanted. And I feel like you're finally getting that in April. Okay. It's going to shock the hell out of you, the Tower card. But I feel like you really deserve this. So good for you. All right. So let's get into your money. Let's get into your money. Actually, let me pull some more cards for career. I kind of want to know what's this surprise or what's this shocking event happening for a Saggy? What's this shocking event happening for Saggy in April when it comes to their career? It's like someone's approving for you to move up. So you're going to get a promotion. But someone's like allowing this to happen. Now, if you don't have a superior or like a boss or anything, it's literally God is like sealing the stamp for you. Because we have Royal Seal here. And then we also have, what is this? This is Former King. So I don't know what this is. It's like something that you really envisioned that you wanted. It was a lot of obstacles with this mountain to get there. But you're finally going to get that stamp of approval. Because I see also here, this is like the public library. So like someone's like approving something for you. And I feel like, okay, now you're finally going to move up, or you're getting approved for a vacation, or both. Yeah. What does it say? Please to King. So you really fought for this. Your boss sees your worthiness, or God sees your worthiness. They're going to give this to you. So you're going to be moving up in April, and you're going to be very happy. Like Ten of Cups, Two of Cups, Three of Cups, something to celebrate for, something to yell from a cliff, like, you know, in excitement. You're going to be super happy about that. So good for you. All right, so now let's move on to your money. What's going on with Saggy's money? What's going on with Saggy's money in April? What's going on with their money? Give me one card. Forgiveness, okay? Someone may be giving you some money because they want you to forgive them, or they'll be giving back to you. You're going to see a lot of people trying to give back to you for forgiveness. If you feel like you've been having bad karma when it comes to your money, you are going to be forgiven in April. You're going to see abundance in your money. Bottom of the deck is freedom. Remember I said something about being free or carefree. Maybe you were too carefree with your finances in the past and now you're being forgiven for that. So you're going to get more abundance, but it's like, okay, now be a little bit more stricter with your budget, or now save, make sure you're saving this time around. So you're forgiven. So you will be getting money, but this time you know what to do with it. Don't spend, save, okay? All right, let's see some tarot for that. Interesting card, Sag. Interesting. Interesting. Okay, let's see. What's going on with Sagi's money in April? What's going on with Sagi's money in April? What's going on with Sagi's money in April, please? Wow, you got the Two of Cups again for your career, and now it's coming out for your money. You also have the Queen of Pentacles and the King of Cups. You also have the Moon card. So this is something that you're not expecting to happen, but it's like God is really pleased with you. Or you ask for forgiveness, right? You ask for forgiveness and it's like, I'm really pleased with you. Okay, because the King of Cups, like, I'm so pleased with you. And we have this great relationship. Some of you guys need to start, if you do believe in prayer, speaking to spirit, speaking to God, you know, showing gratitude, because I feel like it's going to really benefit. And don't do it just because, you know, you want the forgiveness. You do it because you really mean it. And the Moon card, you're not expecting this to happen, okay? And you could have been really sad about your finances once you looked and seen how much, you know, like, it's not going in the place that you want. But someone's very pleased with you here, spirit. And I feel like they're really trying to show you that they're here for you. They won't let you go. Some of you guys could have felt down on yourself with that Moon card, where it's like, oh, you know, I don't know if I'm as abundant as I was before, but you are. They're going to be showing that to you. And Queen of Pentacles, you're going to be very, you're going to be very well taken care of. You're going to get your finances back. Ace of Wands. Okay. So it's like, you know, a new beginning, starting fresh with your finances. You're going to see abundance. But this time too, with the Queen of Pentacles, don't give it all away. Magician, invest, or, you know, work towards your goals and what you're looking towards, finish, like, completing for yourself this year. Some of you guys need to invest in yourself and stop investing in other people. That could have been a reason why your finances were so drained. But I see, like, you're going to be, you know, you're going to be given a good abundance. And it's like, okay, what are you going to do with that abundance this time? Are you going to save it? Are you going to invest it? What are you going to do? Some of you guys need to spend some of this on yourself. But it's not like the Empress. It's not like, you know, buying yourself stuff. It's like investing in your future. With that Ace of Wands. Ace of Wands, please. Five of Swords, okay? It's like, you know where, because I see some of you guys kind of threw like a hissy fit over finances, and I'm not laughing at you. I'm just like, okay, wow, you know, for you to get there, what did it mean for you to get there? What went wrong that made you feel kind of at a wit's end, where you felt so defensive, like, you know, how could this happen to me? But what steps of yourself did you take to get you there? Now you're being given a second chance with that Judgment card, right, with your career. And it's like, what are you going to do this time? Okay. And just know that you do have God on your side, or higher source. This could even be work. Like, your boss will be on your side. Or, you know, don't think everyone's against you, because they're not. It's just a lesson to be learned. Okay. So how would their money be looking then? Some of you guys have a spending issue, okay? Ten of Swords, Knight of Wands. It's kind of making me uncomfortable, because I see that this has made you really upset in the past. But some of you guys feel like, okay, I'm addicted to spending, because the Knight of Wands, why? Seven of Cups. It's just when you have abundance, you're like, okay, what do I want? There's a lot of things that you want. It's like you have to pick one. Seven of Cups. You have too many options of things that you can spend your money on. Pick one thing. Save the other options for the next month. There's like a need to budget for sure. Page of Cups, Page of Wands, okay? Thinking with the Cups energy, right? With your emotions. Oh, I love this. I love that. I need this. I need that. But Page of Wands, am I being smart about this, or am I just overindulging? What's the Eight of Swords? Because I see you really like stopping yourself, or you need to. Yeah, the Four of Wands, okay? This could even be like putting your money in your home, not on like things that you use outside the home. For example, that could even be like maybe you're going on a shopping spree. You're not going to wear any of your super cute clothing outside. So it's like, okay, like buy groceries or spend money on bills, but save the rest. There's a big need for that in April. But I do see you being happy, but you don't want to like get the money and spend it right back. You want to learn that lesson and save this time or invest, okay? All right, so now we're going to get in here. Love life for April. All right, Just Get Here is playing. So you could be long distance from someone, or there's someone who's going to like, either you or someone's going to tell you in April, like, just come over, or I don't know what that is about. Maybe you're going to be spending a lot of time with someone. Hold on. Let's get some cards for your love life. What's happening for Sagittarius' love life in April? What's going on with Sagittarius' love life in April? I'm also going to do new love readings in April, so you should be looking out for that if you're interested. Oh, okay. Okay, we have pleasure and flexibility. Because your schedule is going to be more flexible, you will be able to spend more time with someone. I do see like Two of Cups could be a relationship. I don't know. What else? Give me one more card. Transformation. Nice. Going forward. Okay, so you're either going to be going forward with someone or you're going forward from someone. But whoever you are going forward to, your new person, or if this is even an old person, a lot of pleasure here, okay? A lot of pleasure. This even looks like a wedding arch or like a Four of Wands energy. So pleasurable relationship, bond, flexibility. You and this person do have the flexibility to see each other more often in April. Transformation. Things will be changing between you and this person. I feel like in a positive way, hopefully. Let's start off with the pleasure card. Give me this pleasure card. What is that for Saggy for their love life in April? What does that mean? What does that mean, Spirit? All right, you have a knight coming towards you. It's weird. Definitely have somebody watching you here. It's the weirdest thing. What is this? Okay, you definitely have someone coming towards you for sure that you will be in a relationship with, okay? The weird thing though is that like, okay, you may have had to walk away from this person, or you're walking away from one person going towards another person, okay? And it did leave you kind of sad, okay? There is someone here talking about you, Sag. I don't know. Someone's friends or family are encouraging them to work things out with you, okay? Whatever. But then there's like a little fight. There's like third party energy, like two people fighting over you. Okay. And I don't know who's going to win now. All right. So that's weird. Let's go ahead and go with the flexibility. So we have flexibility. What's this flexibility? Then I'm going to get tarot after we clarify these cards. What's this flexibility? Flexibility, please. Flexibility. Yeah, I do see you going over someone's house a lot. Okay. Interesting. There's someone who may not seem like they have a lot of time for you, but I feel like that's going to change because the transformation card is here. And let me show you why that's there, right? So there's someone here who always wants you around, right? And you may, I don't know, okay? We're not going to talk about it. You see the card. And then, but it's like, they don't have enough time for you. Okay. My mom called this card when I first showed, I show my mom all my cards because we just like to laugh at them. And she called this card when I want to have sex, but he don't. Okay. So some of you guys feel like someone is even too busy to lay it down, which is crazy. And then it's like, you may be really upset with this and you may have to like get consolation from a friend or an elder or family member that you trust. I feel like it's not like that. I feel like this person actually really, really does want you around a lot, but they just need to adjust their schedule. Because someone sleeps better when you're there, but it's like, we're not connecting. And someone really wants you to come around and you always come. All right. Let's see what this transformation is gonna be. I'm dead, yo. I'm dead. Okay, what's this? Because the song playing, like I said, is just get here. All right, so you could be like, okay, but what are we gonna do when I get there? And it's like, just get here, I want you here. But it's like, what are we gonna do? What's the transformation, please? Okay. Interesting. Okay. Oh, nice. Cute. Oh, God. Y'all, transformation. Okay. Look how it started off. Okay. I don't know why you would get your pretty dress dirty for this one, but I ain't judging. Okay. But look how it transforms. Bottom of the deck. Look how it transforms. So I definitely feel like someone's going to be doing something for you, like making more time for you, or roles are going to reverse. If you've been giving more in the energy and it's been really unbalanced in a relationship, you're either going to meet someone new who's going to give you more energy, or you're going to be dating this person. Things will change between you two. I do see a peace offering here. Okay. I do see someone receiving flowers. Okay. Or this can be the feminine gifting someone something as well that makes someone have a change of heart, or it really takes a shift. Okay. And I also see more shared, more shared hobbies and activities together, more dates, more quality time, which we talked about. So that was very interesting. So let's get some tarot. Then we're going to go to the extended, guys. And extended, I'm going to talk about this person and see, I guess we're going to see what this transformation means for them. I'm going to keep out this card. I want to see what this transformation means for them. We're going to go deep into that for them. But first, let's get some tarot. So what's happening in Sagi's love life in April? What's happening in Sagi's love life in April, Spirit? Please give me some cards. Oh, wow. Interesting. Some of you guys, if you are giving too much in a relationship, you definitely want to hold back a little bit, because that's how you're going to get what you want. So you have a king. We have a king of wands here. So you could be dealing with the Aries, Leo, Sag, like yourself. We also have high priestess energy. You could be dealing with a Pisces or a Cancer. But there's something about holding back, because high priestess is someone who's kind of unattainable. They're not really busy. They just kind of like don't jump at every opportunity or every text or every call. And that's going to make someone chase way more than what they were doing in the past. Okay. Hermit as well. Maybe this comes after a break or taking some time within. This is also possibly learning yourself with the high priestess. The high priestess and the hermit is like learning yourself, learning what makes you happy outside of a relationship or a lover. But then we also have the lover. So a very strong connection between you and this person, a big bond is coming, but I think it takes some time after some time off between you two. And then we also have the Ace of Pentacles, which is interesting to me. So a very serious offer is coming in April. Tell me about this serious offer. Tell me about this Ace of Pentacles, please. King of Swords. Okay, so could be an Aquarius, Libra, or a Gemini who's offering this to you, or someone who's usually very cold. Okay, but this person's very intelligent. So if you have pulled away, I can't speak, guys, today. I don't know why. It could be the hookah getting to my brain. If this person has not expressed emotions or given you much time in the past, they definitely have peeped that. They're not slow. They're very onto your cues now. And it's also like this person sees long-term or stability with you, and that's their strength. Their strength is being like a provider, or their strength is being like committed, but their strength is not emotions. So you got to kind of work with this person. You will be receiving a lot of communication from this person. I do feel like they're going to be bothering you like never before. Okay. And I know that's not the best word to use, but I feel like some of you guys do want to be bothered by this person. Like someone doesn't communicate the best, or someone doesn't show enough like attention or like emotion, but I feel like they will be up your ass in April. Okay, what's the lovers? All right, lovers is the Five of Cups. Okay, so after a big disappointment, here comes this energy coming back around. Yeah, Nine of Cups. Some of you guys were sad for no reason, and that, you know, like I said, forgive my choice of words. I don't mean that in an insensitive way. I'm just saying you're actually going to get everything you wanted after all. After the Five of Cups of being kind of sad, you do get wish fulfillment here. And you will be able to overindulge in this relationship. Like, someone's going to be really give you what you wanted. So be careful of what you ask for. All right, what else? Oh, language is here, right? Language is playing. So body language. Okay. So someone knows your body language, even when you're telling them that you feel a certain way. Also getting love language. So you and someone definitely have to learn each other's love languages. It could be very different, but someone's putting that effort in. What's the High Priestess? Tower. Some things could have came crashing down after someone learned something about someone. What did they learn? Chariot. Either something. What the fuck? Yeah, the Devil. Someone could have learned something about, you know, my card that I have in my my deck that I made. There's something about car secrets. So someone definitely found out there's something secretive is about someone's car, who they've been having in their car. Someone could have found that out. Sex in a car. Somebody could have found that out. This could also be like someone moved on, and like Chariot is like moving towards something. Someone could have been moving towards their secretive side, devilish side, addiction side, sex addiction side. I don't know. King of Pentacles. Okay. So it's like after someone was found out, now they're like, okay, but I had this Ace of Pentacles here. I had this to give, but it was like, okay, but you're also sneaky. What's the Hermit? Ten of Cups. Okay. So this is someone that you possibly haven't seen in a while, but you love them a lot, but they're sneaky. That's interesting. Someone could have been your dream girl, dream guy. Like, literally, you could have been in a relationship with this person, but you guys took a break, or you seen yourself being in a relationship, but they're just sneaky as hell. But like, they're going to be giving you more, like, they're going to be really working towards this relationship, Eight of Pentacles, in the, in April. Okay, so let's get the last words. I'm going to take this to the extended, and we're going to go deeper into this message. Yeah, phone me is playing right now. Somebody wants you to call them or text them, okay? Let's get the last words. Give me the last words for Saggies dealing with this lover, whoever this person is, or their love life in April, period. Give me some last words. Give me some last words, please. Not my type in reverse. Okay, that's weird. I think someone was not someone's... Okay, either you're going to be meeting someone who's not going to be your type at first, but you're going to figure out that they are, or someone felt this way about you. I don't know. All right, you could be dealing with a Cancer. Moving on. You could have moved on from a Cancer, or you're just moving on, period. You want to move on from this person. I love how you laugh. So someone's really funny. Or you and this person will be having a lot of funny moments in April. We have Pentacle Daddy, Pentacle Mommy. That's King of Pentacles, Queen of Pentacles energy. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, or someone who's really work oriented or has a lot of stability, abundance in their life, okay? You make me sad. I like you, but not in love. Okay, interesting. We have Ho energy. Okay, that's a feminine energy, okay? We have Ride or Die. Okay, so someone is still expecting you to ride this thing out with them. We have bisexuals, so someone definitely could be bi. We have I'm not over you, okay? We have I'm too good to you / for you, okay? Could be dealing with the Libran. I'm telling the truth. Interesting. So someone knows a secret about someone, but they may not know the whole secret, okay? Okay, so someone could be telling the truth, but you also feel like this person could be a manipulator. And they could be. But sometimes manipulators, sometimes they tell the truth, okay? You can't just count everybody out all the time. We're going to see if this person was lying or not in the extended. We also have Summer. So I definitely feel like you and this person, the buildup of the relationship is for Summer. Some of you guys are going to be in a relationship in Summer. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. Definitely, if you want to book a personal reading, if you want to shop any of the products I showed you in the beginning of the video, if you want to follow my Instagram, follow my second YouTube channel. All those links will be in the description box down below. If you want to follow me to the extended, where we're going to go deeper into this message of transformation for your person, and also see their feelings for you in their next actions and the outcome of April, then you can follow that link in the description box down below. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.